What up, everybody? It's Kyo-kun, a.k.a. Kyo Konamiya, a.k.a. Mr. Controversy, a.k.a. whatever the fuck you want to call me right now. We're about to go in, man. Today, I got two sexy bastards right here, you know what I'm saying, for my first podcast for the Twilight Assassins, and we're about to go in, man. So, you two sexy bastards, especially you over there, you know what I'm talking to. Anyway, but introduce yourselves.
I'm Super Sonic War 15, and I'm ready to kick some, you know, whatever.
Oh, hey, I mean, at least you try to keep it PG. I'm sorry, I have a mouth like a sailor, so if you get triggered for my language, I am sorry.
Hello, everybody. I'm the conundrum, and when YouTube gives you the conundrums in life, I give you the answers with a little side of delirium as well.
Ooh. That was a cool one. I should have said cool. This is super. I should have said this is Super Sonic War 15, and I'm saying keep running or something. But you know what? That's cool.
I could have plugged in my fucking shit. I would be like, yo, you know what I'm saying? Salute me or shoot me or some shit like that. I was like, oh, never mind, man. Like, the conundrum came in this bitch, like, super classy, man. He's not playing.
I'm British, okay? So I'm a classy, limey bastard.
With the fedora. Oh, man. But, yeah, like, we're about to go in on this podcast, you know, about to go in. And a little trigger warning. There's going to be a lot of shit that's going to be said that y'all probably gonna like, but then again, y'all already know how I do. That's why I use the motto, salute me and shoot me. But, yeah, I mean, what topic you guys wanna, you know, start on right now?
Okay, well, I know Conundrum wants to talk about the good old-fashioned doodles for a second. We're gonna have to clear that up, actually, with the whole doodle thing. So go ahead, Conundrum, if you wanna start first.
The thing is, I feel that doodle is basically grasping at straws if he had to do a commentary over a tweet. About Nihilistic Snake using terms of homophobia and ableism because he's always this progressive and stuff, and I wanted to challenge him on it.
Right.
Is knowing Doodle saying that I did this, and it was kind of slimy that.
Hold on, I'm coming. Oh, my bad. Go ahead. Somebody at my door, real quick.
That Nihilistic Snake tagged Doodle in this stuff, saying that this is the reason why Susie hates you. And I'm like, I don't really care if Doodle hates me or not. Doodle, it's not going to be a big deal on me. I have a life. I don't revolve myself around Doodle tones. And my fiance, Delirium. The other words. Doodle hates me or not, it's no big deal. Because in my view, everybody's going to hate you on something.
No. In life. That's true.
Another show that your friend doesn't like. If you have a different hair color. Hell, by the clothes you wear and the card games you play. There's going to be somebody going to hate you in life.
Yeah, basically. You're right about that.
Oh, even said, oh, I do not hate you, and it makes it look like you really like me with all that stuff. I'm like, I don't care. Basically.
Yeah, if you don't basically care, then you don't care. I guess with the whole twit long whatever or something like that. Wait, is this like her third commentary on you anyway?
Yes, it's over Twitter. It's a commentary over my Twitter. And the funny thing is, out of context so easily.
I was about to say that. Yeah, that can be taken out of context or something if you don't know, like you don't know, like how you basically going to like present yourself in a twit longer or at least a twit chain or something when you're trying to like do something. Yeah, this is kind of what I had an argument with somebody about, the whole thing with the whole context or something like that is really needed or something or whatever. But it's like, it's kind of different when you're doing it in text form or something. Like, they won't know what you're doing or something like that from how it is, though. And yes, Doodle Tones was aware that, like, how Twitter is, like, with the whole something like that. But then again, it still can go either way, though, because nobody ain't going to know what you really meant or something on Twitter or something, because people can take things out of context, you know?
And the thing is, I warned a block from Akerlof saying I'm like this M-Skull guy, which I don't even know and I don't give two fucks about. You, because and the other thing, he's blocking people for liking Metacur. So let me guess, Akerlof, should we call you Shives now? And it's stupid, in my opinion, with the commentary community. And my thing is with Doodle, she gets a lot of special treatment when she does poorly researched topics that he doesn't even know of. Tech USA and the other one with Emma Prevost was two of them, and take an example. Corey Margera, because Doodle didn't know shit about wrestling that much or video games, buys into it, and the other people suffer. And even when Doodle disowns the video, be done, in my personal opinion.
Oh, you know what? Speaking of disowned videos or something like that, yesterday I decided to go ahead and just check on the good old Doodles or something like that by looking on her channel. When I looked into it, like, she actually tried to go ahead and listen to some of the good old type of criticism or something. Look, here's the thing of what I'm saying here. When things was going down with the whole CC and stuff like that, and people are basically saying stuff about, like, how people were really, like, getting tired and stuff of the CC and stuff, and people, even some of the higher-ups is trying to quit or something like that just because of some, like that, that's got blown out of proportion or something, or people can't, like, take it, and some people just left the community or something like that just to pursue their own dreams or something. I mean, sure, I believe some people would just basically try to go ahead and quit the CC because they try to go ahead and do whatever they want. That's cool, that's fine. It's just that, why does it only feel like they only basically leave it is because of the drama just getting too carried away? But besides that, Doodle Tones looked like she saw some of the thing or whatever that she saw from how people was basically reacting and stuff. And then Doodle Tones is actually basically feeling a little bit bad about what's really basically going on in the commentary community and thinking that everything was her fault or something. So that's why yesterday or something, she decided to go ahead and put in like these thumbnails or something like that, disowning some of the videos that she basically made. Like, you can actually check her playlist and stuff, and you can actually see some of the stuff that she actually put down with the whole disowning thing, when she was like putting it all down though. So she feels a little bit bad about something though. And how do I know this? Because I remember something in the conversation or something that she was actually feeling like she basically was like feeling like everything was her fault and stuff from somewhere in the private messages.
But at the same time, that's basically putting a band-aid over a really deep cut.
Basically.
All right, I'm back. If y'all hear some stuff, man, hashtag black people problems, my fam is acting retarded right now. But, what I missed?
Keo, I just got done breaking everything down with the whole disowned videos and stuff like that. And, like, you'll probably hear more about that when you look at the recording.
I was just about to talk about that. But like, okay, all right, take my job, man.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it, Keo. You know I wouldn't do that to you. I didn't know you wanted to tackle stuff.
It's alright. I was late anyway.
But also, I kind of talked about the whole the CC with the higher-ups or something like that. Like, again, I explained all that stuff, but we're going to get more into that. So if the conundrum wants to wrap it up with the whole Doodle thing, he can. again, he can say whatever
he
wants.
The thing with Doodle is, Doodle would do more research on his topics, try to understand their points more, and try not to do poorly done damage control, because to me, Doodle tends to put out the fires with gasoline more.
Yeah.
And to anyone who wants to commentate on Doodle Tones, I'll just say this. Hit Doodle Whip instead of the infamous... Because the thing is, with the whole diaper thing, to me, it's more of a cheap shot to me. I'd rather hit somebody with the points and the facts more than their whatever gets their dick hard, in my opinion.
Oh, there you go. There you go. Right. There you go. There you go.
No, I just like how you said that. I was like, yo, you know, just whatever just makes your dick hard, man. Just to let you know, man.
But yeah, Conundrum, you're perfectly correct about that. That's actually one of the examples I wanted to actually go ahead and use. And I'm glad you said that. I'm glad you said that, Conundrum, because I feel the same way, though. Like, I mean, you do, if you basically saw some of my commentaries, you see that I don't really insult people, right?
Hey, man, I'm about to kill all y'all.
Basically, do like whatever or something like that, because I usually decide to go ahead and tackle points or something like that. Okay, sure, you could probably say that I did something with the CanCon thing, with the whole insulting of Halo fan by just whatever. I think the only thing I only said to Halo fan was scrub. I mean I probably said more things, but purple or anything like what people are really saying, you know.
The thing is with Halo fan, I like Halo fan on how many contradictions he does. Like, oh, I'm quitting commentaries. Oh, I'm coming back to commentaries. I'm quitting commentaries.
Okay, that's what else hurt me too with Halo fan, kinda. Like, I don't really care anymore. But hey, if he's trying to go ahead and try to improve himself, that's cool. I don't care. Or he just basically.
Flops more than Mitt Romney half the time.
Yeah, I know what you mean, though.
He's like a politician. He flip-flops on the subject.
That's what he does. He just basically flip-flops whenever he wants. Like, yeah, that's why I was kind of like a little bit, I don't know. I just didn't really care too much about that guy anymore. Like, I didn't know you still kind of like followed the guy too. I mean, I tried to do that so I could see how many times you're going to keep on flip-flopping to what he really wants to do in life. I don't know. I mean, what about you, Kanyam Drum?
Wait. Did I just hear some flip-flopping? Go back for a minute and enlighten me. Pause. What about flip-flopping?
Flip-flan flip-flops most of the time. And it's kind of funny, he flip-flops all the time because he flip-flops more than the typical politician.
Damn.
Yeah, we're talking about Halo. We're talking about Halo fan.
The thing is, if he wants to pursue something better, hell, if he likes Halo so much, he can do Halo reviews, or play Halo live stream it instead of a.
Bruh.
Okay, what's funny?
Wait. It's funny how y'all said that, because speaking of flip flopping, I was on my Twitter like earlier today. I'm not gonna name the person who, because you know I ain't gonna do that. But I seen not just one, but two. No. Three commentators flip-flopping right now. Like, if a lot of them is not clearly dying off right now, a lot of them flip-flopping all over the place. Like in a Yu-Gi-Oh game, it's like basically, oh yo, you see my hand right here? I got the whole field full of traps, but he don't know that. You know what I'm saying? He's like, you know what? I'm gonna play my cards. No, I don't want to play my cards. I'm gonna put that card back. I don't want to put. I'm sitting here like Seto Kaiba's like, gonna fall in that trap, nigga. Gonna fall in that trap. But yeah, all this flip flopping though, man. Like,
a lot of flip flopping right there that people mostly just do or something like that. But that, wait, let me say this though, Conundrum. To answer your question, or at least try to go ahead and pinpoint something or something about that whole Halo or something like that. No, he doesn't like Halo anymore anyway. Like, he just with his avatar. That's it. That's all he does. He just uses Halo as his avatar. You know, Master Chief. Oh my god. Okay, Master Chief. He used this him mostly in his commentaries or something like that, just because.
Right.
He's reminded because since he knows his name used to be Halo Fan HP00, and because since I'm the one that kind of brought him back to how he was before, but hey, I didn't know he was a history book at first when I did a commentary on him.
No, the funny thing is, I never had a problem with the dude. Like, I saw him come up. I remember when I was still, you know, and like, people were sending me stuff on Skype. Was like, yo, do a commentary on this. I just felt like, nah, man, like I ain't going nowhere with this. Like, I don't know. It's like, I never had, like, his junk didn't really super duper bug me. You know, even though, yeah, I can see, you know, his situation, but I don't know. He just never really bugged me that much. I don't know. I just like ignored him or something.
But the thing is, it bugged Danny Dragonstar actually a lot. The thing is, up to the point with him always going after Danny, him and tell him, look, can you ease up on Danny a bit? Opinion, because I was just sticking up for my friend because he stuck up for me on a lot of things.
Oh, also another thing I wanted to talk about for the longest is well, I gotta clear off two things and whatnot, because I have a feeling there's probably some people, you know, because the way I handle things with my Venet and my Venet account and my situation, how a lot of people think I'm like one of the most, like, evilest bastards of all time. Here's the thing. Number one, I am not transphobic. I have countless transphobic friends. Number two, like, I don't necessarily hate Doodletones. I just despise the style and just the stuff that he do. You know, it's like, I feel like, hey, we play some games together, some stuff, you know, some stuff like that. You know, everything be all cool, but it's like, I just ain't feeling those commentaries, dog. I mean, I don't know. It just really makes me cringe, man. Maybe I'm just too old school, probably, because, you know, I came around another time. But I don't know. I'm not dealing with that. And there's a lot.
One thing I'll give Doodle credit on is his knowledge of the game Yu-Gi-Oh. That's the one thing that me and Doodle can have a common ground on.
Yeah. Yeah, I would admit. I admit. Like, I did saw some of those Yu-Gi-Oh columns and whatnot. It's legit.
Plus, that's how I am with Boon Slayer also. And because we both play the games that we know, and we're all brewers in the card game. We don't follow the meta that much. We don't net deck. And when we don't have the proper cards, we'll substitute.
Right.
Just as effective. That's my respect for Doodle as a Yu-Gi-Oh player.
Right, right. I mean, yeah, like I said with the whole Yu-Gi-Oh thing, like, that's all cool. I mean, hell, like, I haven't played Yu-Gi-Oh in a hot minute. Like, I forgot what gen or what situation it was when it's been a while. Like, I used to play it hard. I mean, I used to have the little Star Chips thingy, like. But I actually learned something from some of those videos, because like, the whole game probably changed up now, like,
format.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't know nothing about Yu-Gi-Oh. That's what I get for watching anime Yu-Gi-Oh for, like, when I was 10 years old or something. So skip that.
I got a bunch of guilty pleasure games that I play. Like, I'm good at Bakugan and Beyblade and shit. Like, I was like, I don't know. I would be that weird kid that just liked Bakugan. Like, I don't know. Nobody likes Bakugan for some odd reason.
Because nobody don't want to keep spinning. Okay, sorry. Let's get back to
Beyblade. You don't really spin. About the original
Yu-Gi-Oh! Is they never told you anything about the rules. But then, and I watch Vanguard, the anime, they'll tell you about the rules.
Right.
It's not like Yu-Gi-Oh! The first season where Pegasus snorted a whole bunch of cocaine and just made up his own rules.
But no, I was about to say Kyo and Conundrum. Like, okay, let's actually get right back on point, actually. We just drifted off learning what Yu-Gi-Oh! Is supposed to be.
I mean, that's the norm when it comes to podcasts. Like, there'll be a lot of derailing, bro, you know what I'm saying? Like my podcast, the same thing kind of like my events, man. It's all open season. It's whatever, man.
But I don't want. I just don't want to drift off too much, though.
I got you. But no, I was just letting you know. It's like, yeah, we, you know. It's pretty much. It just is what it is, man. Like, if I want to relate my thing, it would be really close to like how fucking not Colt Cabana. I forgot the guy name. That guy, I forgot, it was some guy, like, he's, like, in the wrestling and shit. He was a wrestler. He'd do, like, the podcast, and they'd be going in on that shit, man. Like,
it's fun to have a little chaos, Supersonic Ward.
Yeah.
But at the time, you have to learn how to have some chaos control in it.
Yeah, true. Hey, I thought I was the shadow around here.
Yeah, I know, a little chaos and stuff. It's just that this always reminds me of another stuff that I've been through with other streams.
Let's get back on the point. Mm-hmm. We're talking about Halo Fan and Doodle.
But
I think he could have handled the Medicare situation a lot better and the Jar situation. But at the same time, he still poured gasoline on that fire. I know about the death threats and stuff, but I always viewed it as, it's the internet. You're going to get death threats. You're going to get... You can't basically... At the same time. On the whole death threat stuff, because in my sense, that's why people view you as a social justice warrior now, Doodle.
Yeah, that's what they do. I mean, that's why they keep on. Okay, here's the thing though. Yeah, Doodle Tones would always keep on actually jumping into like how, like the jar with the whole just the robot type deal or something every time though. And I saw that one. It's like, dang, Doodles, you're doing too much. What's up? You can't. What, like, and freaking Just the Robot, he even basically stepped out of that stuff. But the reason why he even basically came back just because Doodles does keep on talking about it. I can see that. Like, I saw that and stuff. And I don't know why Doodles basically despised that video, though, even though she didn't even basically listen to what Just the Robot had to say about this whole dilemma.
Basically, with the Doodle thing with Jar is like him with T-Moss Boss. And the comparisons are...
And that's kind of funny, because I actually watched that yesterday with Just the Robot and T-Moss Boss. Funny.
Here.
Yeah, that came on my feed, too. I remember that.
Did you watch it yesterday?
Yeah, I watched it.
That was freaking funny.
Believe me, with the as I call it, the Hugbox CC or the CC 3.0. A lot is reason why I never did scripts, and I hate people ask me to do scripts personally, is my emotions.
Yeah, you got it.
And that's one of the reasons why I mostly, because I felt that the CC was trying to take my own creative freedom away, because I view it as my channel.
Yeah, Wait, hold on. I didn't mean to cut you off real quick, but, I always have that one question, like, when, like, this wasn't really a thing necessarily back then with the commentary.
Hello?
Oh, what, goddamn, hold on, let me, I gotta scroll this thing since another person added in. All right. Everybody know my partner in crime. Do I even have to say this nigga name? Just go ahead, man. Plug. Just plug it up.
My name is Donkus.
No, nigga, your real name, you idiot.
My name is Felipe Rodriguez.
YouTube name, actually. There we go.
Sorry. My name.
Attack helicopter when I'm done with your ass.
My name is Obscurian.
Wait.
Kyo, if I wanted to fuck with you even more, I would have just said, my name is Ethan Bradbury. I'm Ethan Bradbury. I'm just flipping my fucking hair.
Why does it sound like saying, like, my name is Blackberry or some shit like that?
Oh, you can black my berry.
Oh my. It's not the weekend yet. But no,
I thought you do that shit with Ward.
Hey, look here, not on the air, man. Not on the air. But yeah, like, what was, oh yeah, like, when did this shit get super duper, like, SJW-like, man, with the whole CC, though, like?
I want to say after the Medicare drama, really? Though it could have been before. Well, no, maybe with that original Jar drama, I believe Conundrum, I guess he knows what I'm talking about, the original Jar and Doodle drama.
Yeah, we was talking about it.
We just got done talking about that, too.
Okay, I guess I'll watch the podcast back. I didn't... but,
I always thought it was before the Jar drama with Kablam Scamdicoot.
Kablam? To be fair, nowadays I don't really think that, like, maybe, but maybe not at the same time.
Ever since...
To be honest, Kablam was just only a fucking edgelord. You know, he's just fucking edgelord.
My thing is, personally, number one, Obscurian, you should have went in and said, my name is Ingo Montoya, you killed my father, prepare to die.
Oh, yeah. Oh, fuck that. I want a reintroduction. I want to come on. Stelios.
Where was that joke? I was going to... Oh, never mind.
My name
is... But hey. Oh, if I really wanted to be a dickhead. What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Jonah Smith.
Oh, chill. No, save that for later. I got something. Oh, my God, chill. No, I was waiting to conundrum.
Kyo, I knew you was going to go ahead and try to bring that up at some point.
No.
But if I really wanted to be a dickhead. Hello, everybody. It's your host, Killer Green Star. Let's get right into the news.
Nah. See, if you really want to be a dick, you come and like, hey, guys. It's YouTube Dude here, and I'm part of the group.
Oh, did you hear that he's actually sort of taken a transition or whatever out of the CC?
What?
I know. I saw. No. I think Kyo. I thought I told you. I told you this yesterday.
I find it funny how people are saying, "Oh, there's nothing to be worried. There's nothing to be worried about with Medicare." When people are fucking leaving before Medicare even gets into the commentary community.
Let me disown all my videos.
Block anybody who's associated with Medicare.
Yeah, I
To
know,
be
right?
fair, Conundrum, no offense, but I almost mistook you for Mad Plushie for with your voice.
Oh, no. Okay, I gotta say this right now. All right, quiet. I gotta say this right now. Look, Mad Plushie, you cool, I love you and all, but
Mad Plushie's
no. No, listen.
Plushie is an asshole for going after Foamy the Squirrel. Never go after the squirrel.
Wait, he's. Anyway, let me finish though. Hold on. I love you and all, but why you mistaken Conundrum for Mad Boy? He doesn't have an adorably like gay
No, it's
lisp.
just that kind of Brooklyn-esque voice. It's just like
Sorry,
a
I'm from
guy.
Philly.
Oh. Well, apologies to all people from Philadelphia.
Home of the shittiest football team that we even disrespect.
He'd be like,
No, to be fair, I like Philadelphia mostly for ECW.
oh, yeah.
I miss going to those shows.
Hey,